Yeah. I'm fully focused,
fully focused.
I got my mind on my money and my money on my mind, and you notice,
and you notice.
I can make a bitch disappear like this. Focus, focus,
focus, focus.
And you notice,
and you notice.
Fully focused,
fully focused.
I got my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
And you ride for me,
and you know that I'm gon' ride for you.
And you ride for me.
Hi babes! Hi, how are you? It's Darla Rose. Hi, how you guys doing? I miss you babes. I'm trying to be on it with the content. I'm so excited. So this stuff is like really old products, but I still haven't even tried it. I was supposed to try it for a video and I've been waiting for so long to do this video. So I did try it. So these are the Colourpop's brushes from the Bare Necessities palette. I did try like two or three of them of these brushes and I really like them. But what I really want to do is kind of new, is I want to try actually every single brush for this look. So I'm going to be trying every single brush and see my thoughts. There are some of these brushes I did try, like I said, and I like three of them from a previous video. But I'm super excited to actually try every single brush and see how they all work from face to the eyes. So these are the Colourpop Bare Necessities brushes. And then, like I said, these are kind of, these are like old products. But what I'm also excited to try is a Jeffree Star Jawbreaker palette. I was obsessed when I saw this, so I had to get it. And I never touched it. I don't know why, but I never used it once. So I'm super excited to be using this. I have like, I already have a look in my head how I want to do it. So I'm super excited. But look at these colors. Like that blue is beautiful. And this hot pink, oh my god, it screams to me. Oh, I love it. Even this purple is pretty, and this color right here, this like neon orange, oh my god, this palette's beautiful. And this yellow, I'm telling you guys, this palette's so beautiful. And look at that mirror. Hi, hello, look at it. It's like, I'm here, use me. All right babes. And then what I haven't tried either is the Brain Freeze highlighting palette. I'm telling you, I don't know why I never touch any of these. I'm so sad. But these are the shades. They're so pretty. I'm so obsessed with this color right here. It's called Gold Breaker. But look, it's like gold with pink and the blues. Oh my god, that's so pretty. I don't know if you guys can like see that. So let's just jump right into this video. I already primed my eyes with my Urban Decay eyeshadow primer potion. I always use it. Oh my god, guys, please ignore my eyebrows. We're in quarantine right now, so I have nowhere to do with my eyebrows. So I'm gonna let them just grow out. But the good part about letting them grow, when I get them done, I will know. I will have a beautiful shape. So I'm kind of like looking at the positive side, okay? I'm going to have beautiful eyebrows once they're done growing out. So you guys are going to see right here, if you guys could see or not. There's like so much hair over here, 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 here. And I just have really bad dry skin right now. I don't know why. So bear with me. Okay. So we're going to go into the Jawbreaker palette. And I want to use this color called Bubblegum, and it's this really pretty pink. I'm gonna bluff that with the Colourpop E16 brush, and it looks just like, let me show you guys, it looks just like this. And we're just gonna pop it like that and pick up this color. I should be careful because I do know better that usually Jeffree Star's palettes do have a lot of pigmentation. Oh, that's a pretty pink. That's really pretty. And this brush is actually a brush I have used prior. And I really like it. It actually reminds me a lot of the MAC brush I use a lot. I don't have it with me right now, but that MAC brush I'm always talking about, it reminds me of it so much. And these brushes are so like soft. Honestly, I only owe two Jeffree Star palettes. It's this one, the Jawbreaker I'm using right now, and then the Morphe collaboration one. I really want to like get more Jeffree Star products. They're really on the pricey side, but I really want to get, I haven't got it, but I'm going to get it eventually, is the Bloodlust one, his purple palette. I love it. I do kind of wish there was more purples in it, don't get me wrong, but seeing like how people use it and then how pigmented it is, and some of those colors in there are just so beautiful. So I'm really like, I really want to try that out. I'm just grabbing a little bit more. I love this. This is like my brush cleaner, like in between my, when I'm using my colors and I want to use the same brush, I just put it in here and it cleans up the brush so good. I got it off Amazon. There's like different brands that make them, so I don't know, it's up to you guys what brand you guys got it, but I remember I got this from Amazon. I think this is the Artistry Makeup Brush Color Remover. And it's really nice, honestly. Like, just to get in between if you want to use the same brush for different colors, it works. Okay, guys, now I'm going to use this. I never use this brush. It's the E17 from Colourpop. It's like a shorter, fluffier one. Pretty fat, but shorter. And I want to go into the color Gumdrop. And it's like that pretty lavender. Kick off the excess, and then we're just going to put that. Oh my god, this color. I didn't think it was going to have that much pigmentation in it. I should have known, but I wasn't expecting like that much. This is a good ass purple, like, because I have known that they say purples are they're really hard to work with, and this purple is so pretty. I wish you guys could see like the full color. I feel like it's kind of like, I don't know if it's my lighting or what, I feel like it's coming off more soft than what it is. So guys, I'm trying to play with the light, see like what can I do to get a little better. But this purple is super pretty. It's like very pigmented. I'm like obsessed with this purple. I really like it. So what I did right now is I cleaned my brush off so it doesn't have like no color on it. So now it's like clean. I'm buffing the pink and the purple together. And I'm definitely gonna add more pink in a bit. But I'm just bluffing that. Bluffing. Why do I keep saying bluffing? Bluffing. Buffing. Buffing.
Say it with me. Buffing.
I'm just buffing the pink and the purple. Okay. Now I think I'm gonna do the pink after. Okay. So now I'm gonna go in with a new brush. And I used this brush too before. It's the E19 Colourpop brush. And so nice. It reminds me of that Morphe. Is it the 506 brush? That Morphe one I like to use. A really small, tight, tight brush. It reminds me of it. And these brushes, I don't know if I said already, they're super, super soft. Like, they're just super soft brushes. They're not hard at all. So they don't hurt you or stab your eye. I'm gonna go in with this pretty blue, like Dodger blue called Soaked. Oh my god, that blue is so pretty. I'm just kind of hitting it off. And then I'm just going to put this kind of right here. Okay. I do have that blue where I want it. Like, it's there. It's definitely there. And I'm going to go back with a previous brush, the E17. And I'm going to go in with that purple and that pink to blend it out. And maybe more pink of it. Like that. Mostly the pink. And we're going to blend this out and make it blend really nicely. And that purple and that blue just blend together like a dream. Like they really blend together nicely. Okay. So I'm liking how the purple and the blue blended, but now I want to go really back into with that pink and really pop that pink in there. So I'm going in with my first brush, which was the E16 and bubblegum, that really pretty hot pink shade. And we're just going to tap this right there. Okay, guys, and I'm just gonna put that blue back in there. And I'm mixing that blue with that purple. Okay, I still want that blue to be very... I want all the colors to blend, but I don't want them to blend completely where they just disappear. I still want them to kind of be visible so you know what colors are in here. Does that make sense? I really like how this eye is coming out better than this one for some reason. But yeah. That is definitely what I'm doing. And I'm just switching with those three blushes. Why do I want to say with the L right now for everything? With these three brushes. And I'm going in with Softly Hands. And when I'm blending them, I'm actually cleaning them between so I don't have no product really in it. Oh yeah, I think that's how I want it. I really want, like I said, colors to pop out on their own, but also be blended. Okay. Now I'm gonna use this flat brush to cut my crease. And this is a Colourpop E3 brush. It's like a flat brush. And I'm going to use some concealer. Let's see how this goes because I never use... Okay. Let's see how this goes, guys, because I always use just my one brush to... clean my concealer, so okay, this brush is nice, but I'm just not used to this brush. I'm used to I'm used to like a brush like this that's angled and it's like a painting brush. So it's not the brush myself this time, but I think it's myself. I'm just not used to this kind of brush to cut my crease. But it is nice because it's so big where it just cuts for itself. But I'm just not used to it. Okay, guys, so I think that looks pretty good cut. It's just I'm used to my brush. I feel like with my brush I could get it really precise, but I think this brush would definitely be, I'm gonna try it though, will be definitely better for like patting on colors on the lid than cutting your crease. But that just me, like I said, I'm just not used to this brush, so yeah. But I am gonna try to blend everything out right now, so we're gonna wet this brush, the same brush I was using. I don't know how this is gonna work. I should use a clean brush, but we're gonna wet it. And then I wanna use this color called Cotton Candy. So what I'm gonna do, like ombre, is I'm gonna use Cotton Candy. What's this one called? Snack. And then this one called Jawbreaker. So Cotton Candy, Snack, and Jawbreaker. Ooh, that's pretty. That is a really pretty neon pink. Okay. Now I'm going to clean my brush. And I'm going to go into that color Snack, which is like that baby pink. Okay. That pink is not like how I thought. It's more like a white. Look at that. It's baby pink, but it's not so... I thought it was going to be a little bit more like an actual baby pink. They're far apart, but just like... I guess because with this pink, it shines so bright. I think I might just do these two then. And I'm just packing those onto my lid. And then I'm kind of doing like an ombre in the middle. That's pretty. And I'm actually, this brush is doing pretty good for being like the concealer brush that you just use with concealer. So it's working pretty good. And honestly, all these colors are so pigmented, it's crazy. I really like how it's coming out on my, I don't know why it doesn't, I feel like you guys can't see like how pretty this looks with my lighting today, but it's coming out so pretty. Oh yeah, that's pretty. That is looking so pretty, guys. Okay, what I wanna do now is blend this out right here. Okay, yeah, so I'm gonna use is this E21. It's like a really fat brush. It's really small fat brush. I probably should have used this actually earlier now that I'm looking at it, but I'm gonna go into that color called Soap. Should that blue that light? And I kind of did it like in the eyeliner way, so I'm like. So I'm gonna use this thing too right here, this brush. This is the E6, and I'm gonna go into it with the blue. We're kind of just doing like liner. Okay, I don't know, maybe this blue is kind of chalky, or is it just me? Like, I'm playing with it a little bit more and more and more. I'm having a really hard time with this blue. Yeah, I think I'm having like a really hard time with that blue. Okay, me and this blue have like some real beef going on right now. I'm about to fight this blue. It's just not working for me, and right now it's on top of my shadow. I'm so sad because I was so hyped for this blue. Or is it just me? Maybe I don't know how to work with blues. Okay, now I'm thinking about it. The Elsa and Anna palette from Colourpop, the Elsa palette, it had that blue and I had so much trouble with that blue. So I don't know, maybe it's just me. I don't know how to work with blues. But then again, the Colourpop has that blue palette. Oh, what's it called? Colourpop has this blue palette called Blue Moon. And I don't know if you guys could tell, but if you guys look at this, like, well, no, it doesn't really look, but it looks, I played with this blue palette so much. And I love it. The looks I do with this palette are so bomb. So I don't know if it's just this blue or if it's just me and I have issues with blue. But there's something going on which I'm not liking. But okay, maybe, but with some time it does blend out how you want it, but you have to like honestly play with this blue a lot, which I don't know if some people really want to do it or they just want it to blend, but this blue takes some time. What I'm doing too now is kind of like I'm outlining it to give it like that really like pretty sharp look. I'm outlining this, and usually when you do this it makes it look really more clean and precise, like you really took your time to cut it out and deepen it. There. I have so much fallout though. I could definitely tell you that. Okay, I still have hope for this look. Don't get me wrong, I still have hope. It's just that blue. I'm gonna fix this right here. So I'm gonna go into that color called Cotton Candy. And I'm kind of just gonna fix whatever that blue took over a little too much of. Okay. So I'm gonna clean. It's looking good, guys. It's looking really good. I'm just gonna clean all this up because it has so much fallout. Okay, guys, so what's next? What I'm gonna do now, guys, off camera, is I'm gonna do my whole base and everything, and then we'll come back to finish the actual eyes. Okay, babe, so this is how it's looking. I'm gonna brush off all this excess powder, and I'm gonna use this fluffy brush. It's the F16, so fluffy. This brush, honestly, when I saw it, it's just perfect just for just sweeping off any powder you have left. And then what I'm going to use is I'm going to use like whatever I have left right here just to kind of set my neck. Ooh, I like this brush. So puffy. That's all I would honestly use this brush for, just to set and also sweep off. Okay, let me see. What do I need to do next? Try and think. Oh, I like to wet my face because in case there is any powder. I'll do it last, actually. We'll do that after. What I'm going to use is this F21 brush. And it's like an angled brush. And I'm going to use this to contour, you know. And I'm not really going to go in depth with what I'm using, guys, just because I will be making a new video soon. And my new video, I don't know why it's looking like that. I'm going to be making a new video soon, and when I do this new video, it's going to be, like, my face routine slash trying a new foundation. And I'm going to go really depth with how I do my face, so I'm not necessarily telling you guys what I'm using or how I'm doing stuff as much. Because this, right now, what I'm doing is more just for the brushes. Because I really like this brush. I really like it for this part. I feel like it goes in there so nicely. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, let's see. What brush do we have next? Okay, so this brush is an F20 brush. It's like a regular fluffy brush. And I'm going to use this for... Let's see. I'm going to use this for blush. That's actually a really good brush. It just does the basics, you know, nothing. You can also use this as like a contour brush if you guys want to. Completely up to you. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, guys. Usually I'll cut this, but I don't feel like cutting it today. I'm going to wet my face. And I'm gonna push any powder that I feel like that's still sitting in my skin that didn't like melt. And I like to do this because it makes like all the powder melt into your skin when you re-wet it and you push it in with your sponge. And if you do like your highlighter too bright or your contour, like this really just softens it up. Oh yeah. Okay. We're gonna set the space. Now what I'm going to use to highlight is this E15 brush. I personally wouldn't use this for my eyes. It's an eye brush, I'm pretty sure. I just wouldn't use it for my eyes. I feel like it's kind of a little too big. But you definitely could. Or this will be a good brush for your eyes if you're just going to do like a simple like two eyeshadows or one eyeshadow just kind of like all over the lid. This definitely would be a good brush for that. I forgot we're going to be using the Brain Freeze Skin Frost Pro Palette. I want to use the color Cold Shoulder and Gold Breaker. Like, just kind of mix it together. Ooh, that is bright. And I learned when you use like brushes like this that are really small for your highlight, you could really like put it where you want it. You have more control than a really big fluffy brush. I'm gonna go in with that powder brush kind of, cause like I did a little too much highlight. And I'm just gonna kind of like soften up the edges. Or what I could also do, but I feel like that didn't work, is you could kind of like clean the brush off, make sure you get all that highlight off, and then use that same brush now that's clean, just to kind of like diffuse the edges. But oh my god, guys, that brush, I like it a lot for highlighting, and this palette is freaking blinding. The highlight, I was expecting. I'm alive. I say I wasn't. Let me try this one here too. Oh, that's pretty. Blind if I didn't expect that, because hello, it is Jeffree Star, a highlighter. So come on, we all know that means that it's gonna be hella bright. So I'm actually not surprised, but ooh, this is so pretty. And what I'm gonna do is use Frozen Fruit. I'm gonna wet it and I'm gonna put it in my inner highlight. And this is just like, I don't know, this is like a really good, like a defined brush, or for like really tight places. I'm just gonna wet it and pop that in right there. And oh my god, that just made a big difference. I don't know if you guys could see that. Okay. I'm obsessed. I'm kind of mad actually that I've been having this highlighter palette and I haven't touched it once. To be honest, I'm kind of upset, but it's cool. It's cool. We got to it. Alright guys, so we're going to finish the eye look. And I want to kind of use my Urban Decay Heavy Metal. This is in Grind. And I kind of just want to just place this like right there. In the middle. I think I need a new one of these because this one's almost empty. Oopsie. Let me see. I'm going to grab that color called Gumdrop. I'm going to pack this onto the bottom. Now this brush to me is a little too like, it's a little too puffy, but I didn't see anything I could really use for my bottom, for the bottom of my eye. So yeah, I feel like all the brushes right now are kind of too puffy for the actual bottom of the eye. So actually what I'm gonna use, because I don't like any of these brushes, I don't like how that came out, I use a Sonia brush. And I actually like this one a lot to apply color underneath my eye. This brush is kind of hard though. I'm not gonna lie. I like using it, but it's not that soft, honestly. But I just like how it applies the bottom. How it applies eyeshadow on the bottom, so I just got kind of like used to it. And then I'm gonna grab Salt. I'm just gonna kind of connect that like that. And I'm just gonna bring this into like halfway. I have that where I want it. It looks really, really pretty. So I'm just gonna apply mascara and then some bottom top, some falsies, and then the lip, and then we'll be done. We'll show you guys the final looks. 1, 2, 3. What do you guys think, babes? This is the finished look. I am loving it. I really, really love how it came out. I feel like the eyelashes make it. And then I feel like how I clean it up just gives it like that Botox look. I don't know, I just love this look. What I put on my lips is just to make it right, because we've been using just Jeffree Star products mostly. It's one of those mini ones, his mini nude ones, semi your nudes lip collection. This is in Family Jewels. I freaking love this color. It's so pretty. And the formula for his Lip Quid lipsticks is so bomb. It's just amazing. Like, they feel so light on your lips and they don't stick or nothing. I freaking love his lipsticks. I actually do recommend buying these. Okay, so guys, so what do I think about the ColourPop brushes? I actually really like them. They're very, very, very soft on the eyes. I didn't use E18 or E4. These two brushes, I don't know what I would use it for. Maybe like, I don't know. I don't really know. Maybe for like patting on your eyelid or something. I don't know yet what I would use these for, but I really, really like the brushes. This brush is just amazing just for like all over the face, but I will say it sucks when you want to get like in a really good, like a little corner. You're not going to be able to do it unless you like pinch it like that, but overall, it's really good. Like I said, I actually like these brushes a lot. They're very soft, so I would recommend these brushes definitely. I would definitely be using them too in my everyday routine. For the Jawbreaker palette, I really, really like this palette a lot. The formula was bomb, super pigmented. The blue, I don't know. To me, it gave me problems, but I don't know if it's just me. I don't know how I work with blues or what, but the blue wasn't really my favorite. Like, in this eye look, I wanted to have more of a deep blue. Like, it was supposed to be like blue, purple, pink, maybe the way. I'll probably redo this look again, maybe, and try doing it in a different technique, because I want the blue to show way more, and I feel like it just doesn't show. It just went to like a purple. But I do think this palette is freaking bomb, and I love it. I think it's so beautiful, like this color right here, orange juice. Oh, look at that. That is so pretty. And then this color called Lemon Drop, freaking pretty. This hot pink called Cherry Wet or Cones, like a really nice transition color. So I really, really like that. So I definitely want to play with this palette a little bit more, get some different ideas. So if you guys see this video, comment down below like what colors I should play with, like what color theory. Maybe I'll try that blue again, or I'll go to like the greens and the orange or something. I don't know yet, but I need to play with this palette a little bit more. But I do like it a lot. The formula was pretty bomb, except that blue. And now the Brain Freeze palette. Bomb! But if you already know, Jeffree Star makes the bombest highlighters. I'm like obsessed with them. And I'm so sad but happy that I finally got to use this, because that highlight is just so freaking good. Like, you just go into little this, maybe into this, and just look at like instantly just hits the skin and just shines. Like, his highlighters are pricey, but they're definitely worth it, because even like his regular highlighter, I'll show you one right now, I think they're like $30 or so, around there. But look at how big this is. Like, it's the size of my hand. And then look at this. You get so much product for the price point, so it is definitely worth it. This is actually like one of my favorite shades. This is Peach Goddess. But I definitely recommend, if you guys are looking for like a good highlighter, Jeffree Star. Freaking bomb highlighters. But yeah, babes, this is the finished look. I hope you guys like it. So bye.